Good afternoon, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to study about interrogative pronouns. So we know that whose, which, who, whom, and what. These words are called interrogative pronouns. Let's understand them. Although I have told you about this all the pronouns in our previous class, so I will give you a quick overview regarding this. Then we will do some exercise. So I told you which pronouns are used to ask questions like who, whom, what, whose, which. These words are called interrogative pronouns, right? Then I told you who, whom, whose, and which are used for people. So when we talk about human beings, so we should use who, whom, whose, and which. And for things, means for objects, we can use what and which. After that, I told you who can be used like for person, like if I say, who are you? It means I'm talking about a person. See the example of whom. Whom do you want to meet? So same, I'm talking about a person. Next, whose is this pen? Owner must be of any person. So we are talking about a person. Next, two students are standing there. Which is your favorite student? So I'm talking about a person, a student. A student is a person. So simply, dear students, I want to make you understand that who, whom, whose, which can be used for people. Next, what and which can be used for things like what do you eat? I'm talking about anything. Like it can be any, like any eatable thing. It can be pizza, it can be Maggi, it can be chow mein, whatever you want to eat. Next, which is your favorite shirt? So shirt is a thing, that's a non-living thing. So for which means like for like what and which, these two words we can use for things. And what, sorry, who, whom, whose, when, which. These are used for people. Next, I told you like how to use these words. Firstly, I told you about who word. Like if I say who, then I need to ask about the subject of the verb. Like suppose our sentence is that Virat plays cricket. We know that Virat is subject in this sentence. And anyhow, if you want to ask about the subject, so we should use who word. Like I can ask, who plays cricket? So by the who, I want to know about the subjects. So when we want to know about the subject, so we should use who word. See the next example. My mother prepares food. So my mother is a doer of action. So she is the subject. Right? See, if I want to know about the subject, who prepares food? So who can be used to ask about the subject? Right? Let's understand about whom word. To ask the indirect object of verb. Indirect object means like when we put object and that is living being, it means that is indirect object. Like if I say, I teach my students. So my students are here indirect object. Suppose in any sentence, I want to ask about indirect sentence, indirect object. So I should use whom word, like, whom do I teach? Main kisko padhata hun? Answer is I teach my students. So my students are here indirect object. So if I want to know about the indirect object, so I should use whom. My father always helps me. So me is indirect object here. So if I want to know about me, so I should use whom. Whom does your father help? Right? Let's talk about the what. What is used to ask about particular information? If you want to know about the particular information, so I should use what. Like, what do you play? So I want to know about the particular information, like which game you play that. Next, what do you wear usually in a party? Neha, please stop the video. What do you wear usually in a party? So I want to know the particular information about your particular dress, which you usually wear in the party. Or the style of the dress, right? So when I want to know about the particular information, so I should use what. Next, whose. About whose I told you. To ask who belongs to something. When we want to know about the owner of something, then we should use whose word, like whose is this pen. So I want to know who belongs to that pen, means who is the owner of that pen. So I need to use their whose word. I usually like my brother's company. Whose do you like? Means whose company you like, right? So I want to know who belongs to something. For this sense, I should use whose word. I used Mohit's notebook. Whose do you use? Means whose notebook did you use? I want to say like that. So whose can be used when we want to know that who belongs to that thing, right? Next, which to ask to be exact about one or more. When we want to be exact about one or more, in that condition, we should use which word, like, I will wear the new dress in the party. Which will you wear? Right? Means, I want to know about your dress. I want to be exact about your dress, which dress. So that's why I need to use which there. I will choose English and Hindi subjects. Which will you choose? So I want to be exact about your choice. So that's why I'm using their which word, right? Okay, so for these sense, we need to use these interrogative pronouns. Now, on the behalf of this understanding, dear students, I want to do this exercise. Fill in the blanks. So you need to raise your hand if you know the answer. My first sentence is that, did you invite to start the meeting? So which interrogative pronoun will come here? Please tell me. Who can give me the answer? Please raise his or her hand. Which interrogative pronoun can come here? Okay, let me do some setting from my end. Let me enlarge this box so that I can see the hand of everyone. Okay. Ansh, you please tell me which pronoun will come here.
Sir, who?
Who? But a who will not come because already subject is given there. Subject is given there. So who we can't use. Something else we should use. Lavisha, can you guess? Lavisha, can you tell? I request all the students, please, if you do not know the answer, if you do not want to give the answer, so please don't raise your hand. Manishita, you please, you have raised your hand. Can you try? Whom will come here? Very good, right answer, because we are talking about any indirect object. Right, suppose I want to say that I invited the principal ma'am to start the meeting. The principal ma'am is object, that is indirect object. So here I want to know about the indirect object, right? That's why whom we need to use. Who we can't use because subject is already given there, right? So whom is like right word here. Next, do you want to do? Do you want to do? Karna chahte ho. Which pronoun will come here? Vivek, will you tell? Vivek, please unmute to yourself. You have raised your hand. Yes, Vivek.
Sir, what do you want to do?
What?
Sir, what?
Okay, yes, very good. Right answer. So what will come here? So we need to say, what do you want to do? Means we want to get the particular information. That's why I have to use what here. Very good. Right answer. Next sentence, of these books will you take? Of these books will you take? So which pronoun will come here? Sai Prateek, you please tell. Unmute to yourself. Yes, Peta, please tell me.
Sir, which of these books will you take?
Which of these books will you take? Very good, right answer, because we want to be exact about the book. So that's why we need to use here which. Very good, right answer. Next, said these words. Said these words. So which pronoun will come? Who can let me know? Reet, beta, you please tell me. Reet, I hope you can give the right answer. Yes, Reet.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon, Reet. What can be the right
answer? Sir, what said these words?
Again, like say please, I did not understand.
What said these words?
What said these words? Reet, beta, you have tried well, but what will not come here? Who will come here? Who said these words? Because we need to get an object here. So a subject here. So if you want to get subject, so it can be a person. So we need to use who here. Who said these words? Ye words kisne kahe? Right? So we need to use who here. Very good. You have tried well. Don't be afraid to give the answer, but you should try to give the right answer. If that is wrong, that's okay. That's fine, because we all are learners. We are not perfect. We are learning the things. Okay, by mistake, I have shown the answer. So is this sweater? So we need to say whose is this sweater? Whose is this sweater? Okay. Next sentence, to are you speaking? To are you speaking? So which pronoun will come here? Neha, you please tell me. Neha will give me the answer. Neha, please tell me the answer. Yes, Neha. Try, please.
Sir, what are you speaking?
But two is there. Two word is there. So if two is there, what will not come? हम किसी person से बात कर रहे हैं. What नहीं आएगा? Person के लिए what नहीं use करते. Again try, Neha. You are very close to the answer.
Sir, who?
Okay, who? Actually, whom will come here? Because subject is already given there. So we need to say, to whom are you speaking? Tum kisse baat kar rahe ho? To whom are you speaking? Right, Neha? Okay, next sentence. Of them wants to see you. Of them wants to see you. Which pronoun will come here? Love Kumar, you please tell me. Love, can you tell? Okay, I think he does not want to give the answer. Ishika Rana, you please tell me. Ishika, can you tell?
Sir, which of them wants to see me?
Which of them wants to see me? Very good. Right answer. Which will come here? Because which word we can use when we talk about the human beings. And for to be exact, we need to use which. So that's why which is right answer here. Next, do you want for your birthday? Do you want for your birthday? Which pronoun will come here? Who will let me know? Let me see any new student. Love, again, I give you the chance. Can you give me the answer? Okay, I think he does not give the answer. Love, can you give the answer?
What do you want for your birthday?
Very good. Right answer. What will come here? Because we want to get the particular information. So that's why we need to use what here. Very good. Right answer. So now let's talk about reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. Now everyone, please down your hand, because next term we are going to understand. So that's a grammatical point, reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. Let's understand them. So both the pronouns have same forms. Okay, so like reflexive and emphasizing pronouns, both are having the same forms. Like if I say myself, that is reflexive pronouns also, that's a emphasizing pronouns also, right? So if I say ourselves, reflexive and emphasizing pronoun, both are same formation. Next, yourself or yourselves, both are reflexive and emphasizing. In same way, himself also, herself also, itself also, themselves also, right? These all the pronouns are called reflexive pronouns and emphasizing pronouns according to their formations. Next, use of reflexive pronouns. Firstly, let's understand how to use reflexive pronoun. Then we will do the exercise regarding this. When subject and object are the same person or thing, we should use reflexive pronoun. I'm saying this, dear students, you know that. Let me take the marker. Okay. You know that this is a verb, right? And this is the subject and this is the object. This point we know all that before the verb we need to write the subject and after the verb we need to write the object. Love Kumar, please stop the video. Right, dear students? So I want to say that like in this, Mohit is someone else and Rohit is someone else. Both are different person, right? So I'm saying that when subject and object both are same person, so in that case we should use reflexive pronoun, like Mohit slapped himself. In previous sentence, I told Mohit slapped Rohit. Mohit ne Rohit ko mara. Mohit is subject and Rohit is object. But in this sentence, Mohit slapped himself. Mohit ne apne aap ko slap kiya. Apne aap ko thappad mara. Right? So I want to like show you that Mohit and Rohit, Mohit and himself, we are talking about the same person. Okay, but in the first sentence, Mohit is someone else and Rohit is someone else. I want to say you when subject and object are the same person. In that case, we should use, right? Neha, please don't do that. Otherwise, I will remove you from the meeting. Okay. Next, we should not hurt others. We should not hurt others. Next, we should not hurt ourselves. In this, you can understand that subject means we and ourselves. Both are like same person. So that's why we have used here ourselves. Hame apne aap ko hurt nahi karna chahiye. So in that case, I need to use reflexive pronoun. Clear, dear students? Next, she blamed me for her problem. She is subject and me is object. She is someone else and me is someone else. But if I use same person in object and in subject, then I need to use reflexive pronoun. Like she blamed herself for her problem. So subject is and subject and object both are same person. She blamed herself. Usne apne aap ko blame kiya. So that's why we need to use here reflexive pronoun. Simply you can understand when in objective case, you need to fill the subject, or you can understand when subject and object both are the same person or thing, we should use their reflexive pronoun, right? Manishita, please down your hand. Use of emphasizing pronouns. It is used to convey emphasizing emphasis. Yesterday, I myself prepared the food. So dear students, whenever we have to emphasize on subject, so in that case, we should use emphasizing pronouns, which are like myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself. These are the emphasizing pronouns too. Like you can understand this sentence. Yesterday, I myself prepared the food. Kal, maine khud apne aap khana banaya. So I want to emphasize on myself. I want to highlight myself, right? That's why I need to use myself here. See the next sentence. He himself said to me to do that work. Usne khud mujhe kaha wo kaam karne ke liye. Right? I want to emphasize on subject. That's why I need to fill here him. Him will come according to subject. If subject is he, we need to fill himself. If subject is I, we need to use myself. If subject is we have to use ourselves. So according to the subject, we should fill these reflexive or emphasizing pronouns. They themselves called us. उन्होंने खुद हमें बुलाया. I'm emphasizing on they. That's why I have used here themselves. Right? So emphasizing pronouns emphasize the subject and reflexive pronoun show that like subject and object are the same person. Now, dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, let's do this exercise. So my first sentence is that, firstly, read the statement. Sentence, the state the type of the given underlined words. So which word is underlined here? So you need to tell me is that is the reflexive or emphasizing. She herself cut her hair yesterday. So is that reflexive or emphasizing? Who will let me know? Yes, please. Ansh, you please tell me. जिस वर्ड को अंडरलाइन किया गया है वो रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन है या एम्फसाइजिंग प्रोनाउन है?
सर रिफ्लेक्सिंग.
रिफ्लेक्सिव, बट दैट इज एम्फसाइजिंग. बेटा रिफ्लेक्सिव तब होगा जब उसको ऑब्जेक्ट की जगह लिखेंगे. राइट? तो यहाँ पे ऑब्जेक्ट क्या है? हर हेयर. सब्जेक्ट क्या है? शी. तो ऐसे भी समझ सकते हो व्हेन वी पुट लाइक सच टाइप ऑफ प्रोनाउन जस्ट आफ्टर द subject, so these are the emphasizing pronouns. Okay, when we write them instead of object, so these are the reflexive pronoun, but here that is a emphasizing pronoun. Right? Next, I locked myself in the house. I locked myself in the house. Reflexive or emphasizing? Manishita, you please tell me.
Sir, emphasizing.
No beta. दोबारा बेटा मेरी बात को समझो. अगर सब्जेक्ट के साथ में लिखा होता है तो वो सब्जेक्ट को एम्फसाइज कर रहा होता है, उस समय वो एम्फसाइजिंग प्रोनाउन होता है. परंतु जो ऑब्जेक्ट की जगह लिखा होता है, ऑब्जेक्ट का मतलब है कि वर्ब के बाद, लोग यहाँ पे वर्ब है उसके बाद लिखा हुआ है, तो वो रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन होता है. ठीक है? तो यहाँ पे क्या है? रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउन. ओके, यू हैव ट्राइड वेल. ओके, नेक्स्ट विवेक मान, यू प्लीज टेल मी.
Sir, reflexive pronoun.
Reflexive pronoun. The car adjusts itself. Yes, very good. Because as an object, we have used it. So car and itself both are the same thing. So that's why reflexive pronoun is that. Next. He himself cooked a meal for dinner. He himself cooked a meal for dinner. What type of pronoun is this? Reflexive or emphasizing? Vanshika Goyal, you please tell me.
Sir, reflexive.
No, beta, that's emphasizing pronoun here. Because we are emphasizing, हम जो डाल रहे हैं यहीं पे, हम दिखा रहे हैं अपने आप को. He himself cooked a meal for dinner. उसने खुद ब खुद, यानी कि अपने आप, खाना बनाया डिनर के लिए, मील बनाई डिनर के लिए. Right? So after the subject, if you put that is a usefully emphasizing pronoun. Okay. Next, she usually talked to herself in front of the mirror. So now, tell me the type. Lavisha, you please tell me.
Sir, reflexive.
Very good. It's the reflexive pronoun. Because instead of object, we have used it. Very good, right answer. So I hope now everyone has understood about reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. So let's do this exercise too. Fill in the blanks with suitable reflexive or emphasizing pronouns. Okay, so suitable reflexive and emphasizing pronouns you have to fill. First sentence is that you are holding a sharp knife. Be careful lest you should cut. Either you have to fill here reflexive pronoun or emphasizing pronouns. Formation is same. But tell me which pronoun will come here? Myself, yourself, himself, ourselves, or themselves, or herself. Which pronoun will come here? So who will tell me? Sai Prateek, you please tell me.
Sir, yourself.
Very good. So yourself will come because our subject is you. So according to you, we need to fill yourself. Okay. Next. I saw the masked thief. I saw the masked thief. So which pronoun will come here? Who will let me know? Vivek Man, you please tell me.
Sir, himself.
No, beta. Myself. According to subject, you can see that subject is I. So according to I, we need to fill here myself. If subject is he, then we have to fill here himself. Again, understand? Agar hamara subject I hai, to I ke according hume myself fill karna hota hai. I ka jo reflexive ya emphasizing pronoun hota hai, wo myself hota hai. Usi tarah we ka hota hai ourselves. Usi tarah you ka hota hai yourself or yourselves. मैंने जो आपको टेबल दिखाई थी पहले उसमें सब कुछ मेंशन था, उसी तरह ही का होता है हिमसेल्फ, शी का होता है हरसेल्फ, और इट का होता है इटसेल्फ, और दे का होता है देमसेल्व्स. ओके, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू सब्जेक्ट वी नीड टू फिल. नेक्स्ट इज दैट शी अग्रीड टू हेल्प मी. व्हिच प्रोनाउन विल कम हियर? लेट मी सी दैट. Praneet, please tell me. Praneet, you please tell me.
Herself. Sir, herself.
Yes, very good. Right answer. Herself will come here. She herself agreed to help me. Very good. Right answer. We will support you. We will support you. So which pronoun will come here? Who will let me know? Ansh, you please tell me. Ansh, can you tell? Okay, Sai Prateek, can you tell? Sai Prateek, can you tell? Okay, I tell you. Here, ourself will come because reflexive or emphasizing pronoun of we is ourselves. Okay. Next, my father helped to clean the AC. So which pronoun will come according to my father? My father is third person singular, that is the masculine gender. So I tell you this answer of this here, himself will come, right? If I say that my mother, then herself will come. Okay, if I say my parents, then themselves will come. Okay, so according to my father, that is third person singular, masculine gender. So we use pronoun for it, he. According to he, we need to fill here himself, right? Now the students can monitor. So which pronoun will come here? That's a quite tricky sentence. Let me see who can give me the answer of this. Ansh can give the answer. Ansh, can you give?
So the student can monitor herself.
Okay, I tell. Here we need to fill themselves. Okay, दोबारा समझो, अगर कोई नाम आता है, अगर वो नाम किसी बॉय का है तो हिमसेल्फ, किसी गर्ल का है तो हरसेल्फ. अगर वो बॉय या गर्ल एक से ज्यादा हो, चाहे वो बॉयज हो या गर्ल्स हो, कोई भी हो, तो हम themselves होना. यहाँ जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं, वो एक से ज्यादा हैं. So that's why we need to fill here themselves. Okay, right? Now we will understand relative pronoun, but not in this class. In next class, we will understand about the relative pronouns. Okay. Now, dear students, I will send you today answer key. In the answer key, letters will be written there, or some diary entry will be there. So all the letters and diary entry you have to write in your fair notebook. Okay.